kicked off Macworld Expo by announcing some new products. Hi, I'm Narasu Rebbapragada here at the Apple booth to take a look at them. The MacBook Air is every bit as thin and light as the promise. I picked one up earlier, and it had been on for some time, but it didn't feel hot to the touch. It felt warm, but not hot. On the right side of the machine, if you flip down a little door, you see a USB 2.0, micro DVI, and headphone port. Now, that means that you won't be able to connect a FireWire camera to the MacBook Air. You'll need a USB 2.0 device. And if you want to hardwire to a network, you'll need to buy a USB 2.0 to Ethernet adapter in order to be able to do so. Now, the base price of $1,799 comes with a hard disk drive. If you want to upgrade to the newer solid-state drive, you'll have to pay a whopping $999 extra. Ooh, that's a lot. The multi-touch trackpad supports some very cool iPhone-like gestures. For example, you can take two fingers to pinch, zoom in and out of a page. You can take three fingers to flick, do a page up or page down motion, as well as two fingers to rotate. Now, one thing we did notice is that you will not be able to replace the battery yourself. It's hardwired into the device. You'll need to take your MacBook Air to an authorized service dealer. Overall, it's a really great notebook, thin and light for, say, business professionals, someone who wants, you know, mobility on the go. For graphics professionals, video or otherwise, you'll probably want to choose one of the other Apple laptops. While we were here, we checked out some of the other Apple products, like the Apple TV. Now, it has outputs both for HDMI and component video. Now, it only supports 720p resolution, so if you have a 1080p television, it will connect to it, but will up the resolution from 720p to 1080p, so you won't get the exact sharpest picture that your TV can display. We also took a look at Time Capsule, Apple's wireless network-attached storage device. Now, if your home network contains Macs and PCs, your PC will be able to see Time Capsule as a drive volume. Time Capsule also has a USB port, so you can hook up an additional external drive and see that as a volume. But of course, to take full advantage of Time Capsule's functionality, you'll need to connect it to a Mac running macOS 10 Leopard, which integrates Time Machine, and that's Apple's backup and versioning software. These products will be available in the next couple of weeks. Apple is already taking pre-orders for the MacBook Air. Overall, we're really impressed with Apple's industrial design again. Till next time, I'm Narasu Rebbapragada. Thanks for watching.